Okay. Now the first question just says that construct a Moore machine. So keep that in mind. What is Moore? The output of Moore machine depends upon the present state. Keep that in mind. And that takes a binary number as input and produces a residue 3. Okay. So it is another way of saying that mod 3. Okay. So mod 3 as output. What it means that if something, if I just take some binary number, so this is your binary number 0001101. Okay, so in decimal it is 0, this is 1, and this is 2, and this is 3. Okay, so it is saying that whatever now the input here is input, the if I say input alphabet here is 0 and 1. Okay, so only 0 and 1 is possible. So I'm just writing the shortest length string. So another shortest length string will be 0 and 1. Okay, so this is 2 length string, 3 length string, 4 length string, any length string is also possible. So I've just taken this length string to make it more clearer. Okay, so it is just saying that whatever you got, you just take a mod of it. So I 0 0 is 0, so 0 0 0 mod 3 is 0. In the same way, 1 mod 3 is 1. In the same way, 2 mod 3 is 2. In the same way, 3 mod 3 is 0. Okay, it is just saying that whenever you get some input, suppose this is input 0 0 1, so divide that input, this is binary, divide that input with the take the mod of that input with 3, and whatever be the answer here, that should be the output on that particular state. Okay, so that is what is this question saying. Okay, so suppose I just start with the first one. I just only starting with the first state. First you should try it yourself. After that I will tell you the solution, don't worry about that. So first is that Q naught. Now I just do a now I know that 0 divided by 0 modulus 3 is 0. So any number of zeros modulus 3 is also 0. So I don't need to worry about that. So I can do a self loop of 0, and if I do a modulus of this 0, any number of zeros with 3, it will output me 0. Okay, so if you got my point here. So I just go one step further. Now in this Q naught, 0 is already defined. I'm defining 1. So any number of zeros followed by a 1 in binary is again 1 in decimal. Okay, so its modulus with 3 will result with again 1 here. So what will be the answer here? That it will be going towards the state Q1, and with the output that it is containing a output of what? Output of 1. Okay, so any number of zeros followed by a 1, if I take a modulus of that with 3, then I will get output of 1. In the same way, now you should try to complete this, because this is a mod 3 question, you know the number of states will be 3. Okay, so I just draw like this. Now only the output that is remaining is 2, so most probably the output here will be 2. Okay, so now try to complete this question. Now if you understand the problem, complete this question, I will tell you the solution in like 2 or 3 minutes. Okay, so now there are 3 states, every state has 0, 1 and 2 output associated with each state. Okay, now just go with the transition diagram, transition symbol on Q1, transition symbol on Q2, just define it for 0 and 1. Okay, so let's see who can do this and share your screenshot. Okay, just take like 5 minutes, try every possible combination. Okay, I will tell you the solution in like 2, 3, 5 minutes. Okay, so just try it. It is a little bit difficult, but if you should try every possible combination. Okay. Okay, so I think Mayank has given the answer. 100, that is 4, that is correct. 10, any number of ones. 1015 modulus 3 is also, yeah, absolutely correct. Okay, so the answer given by Mayank is absolutely correct. Okay, so if you see how did he reach there, just go with the smallest string. Do not worry about anything else, just go with the smallest string. Okay, so now I know that here there is a possibility of 0 and a 1. I haven't defined 0 and 1 on Q1, and on Q2, 0 and 1 is not defined. Okay, so the simplest solution, as you know, that either on this arrow there will be a 0 or there will be a 1. Okay, so I just try, what should I try? Let me try a 1 here. Okay, so if I try a 1 here, what will happen? That it will become 3. Okay, so that is any number of zeros followed by two ones. Okay, so now it will 1 1 divided by 3. It means 3 divided by 3. So the output should at Q2 should be 0. Okay, so that means that I cannot divert this 1 to this Q2 because it has an output of 2. Okay, so what can I do? Where am I getting the output 0? That is at Q0. So I just divert this to this one. Now I am getting output on Q0 as 0. Now do not stop there, just check for multiple strings that it is correct or not. Okay, so now 1 1, now this becomes 3, so 3 modulus 3 is 0, 1. Okay, so 1 1 1 is 7, 7 modulus 3, 3 is 2 is 6, that means that the output should be 1. So it is ending at Q1, the output is 1. Okay, so that is now 1 1 1 1, so it should be 0, 1 1 1 1. So 1 1 1 1 is what? 15. 15 modulus through 3. 3 5 is the 15. It means 0. So I think that you got the right diversion of this one here. In the same way, now here I have to define 0. So what can I do? So 0, I cannot do a self loop here because I have to define something on this arrow here. So I just define the 0 here. So now 1 0 is what? It is your 2. So 2 modulus 3 is 2. So that is, I think that sums up quite beautifully, that connects it very right here, that automatically I got a 1 0 and we got output of 2. Okay, so that is correct, that the transition here is correct. Now I have to do a transition of a 0 and a 1. So that is that, only that thing is remaining here. Okay, so how can I do the transition of 0 and 1? So just give it a self loop first. So I'm trying to give a self loop of 0. Okay, so first I'm trying the self loop of 0. What will happen? It will become 100. So this is the smallest string that I'm trying. So 100 is what? 4 modulus 3 is 1. So again, it is not getting right here because I have the output of 2 here. So what can I do? I can divert this 0 where the output is 1. So where the output is 1? Where is the output 1? At the state Q1. So I am diverting this 0 to this 1. And I know that now the self loop is not possible for 0. Okay, so now check for multiple string that 100 is 4 modulus 3. I'm landing at Q1. So again, take 2 zeros also. Okay, so I'm again landing at Q1. So 100 00. Okay, so it should get me a modulus of 1. So just see what is this, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. So 16 modulus 3. I think 3, 5 is the 15 and it is again 1. So the diversion of this 0 on this Q2 is, I think, very, very correct. Okay, so in the same way, now there is a only one thing remaining, that is the 1 here. Okay, so just try the smallest string, that will be your 101. Okay, so 101 modulus 3, meaning 5 modulus 3 is 2. So that, I think, that is a correct one. 5 modulus 3 is again 2. We are getting the output of 2 here. In the same way, check for one other string, 10. Any number of ones can come, so I'm checking 1011. So 1011 is what? 1 2 4 8 8 3 11. 11 modulus 3. 11 modulus 3 is what? 3 3 is the 9, I think 2. Okay, so again we are landing at Q2 and we are getting the output of 2. Okay, so I think the self loop of 1 is the correct transition here. Okay, so if you clearly see that I have to go through many, many number of states, I have to do a multiple number of checkings that where I'm diverting the string is correct or not. okay, because this is a modulus 3 counter. If you see this mod 3, I know that I will only get 3 states. Okay, so always in modulus 3 counter, keep that in mind. If modulus 3, in modulus 4, if you have a mod and you will get n number of states, keep that in mind. Okay, so I have told you multiple number of times here. Okay, so if you are able to draw it, that is well and good. There is another shortcut here, and that is also valid in many scenarios. In all the scenarios I have tested it. So what is the shortcut here? That first, that is your transition table. Okay, so transition table. Okay, because this is a modulus 3 counter, so the number of states will repeat itself after 3 number. Okay, I will tell you what I mean. So first, just write the states here, Q0, Q1, Q2, because I know that that mod 3 will have a state of 3. So I just write it like this. After that, there will be an input here. After that, there will be output. So every state associate, now the output here, the output set here is 0, 1 and 2. Okay, so this is the outset set, because if you do a 3-3 modulus, 3 will become again 0. So the output set is this. So just write the output as it is 0. Every output is simply associated with the state. So 0 is associated with this, 1 is associated with this, 2 is associated with that. Okay. So now if you want to draw a transition table, just now clearly, this is a very good shortcut. See what happens. Just write Q0, Q1, Q2, then Q0, Q1 and Q2. Okay, so that transition table is also the same thing as the diagram. Okay, so this is the same. If you draw it in a diagram, you will get the same answer. So how this is working exactly, that we are working in a mod 3 counter. So what happens is that the 3 states, 1, 2, 3, after that 3 state, again the states are repeated, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so if there are multiple states, that it will be repeated by 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so if I just change this question and I say that there are binary strings here, and the modulus and the residue 4 you have to calculate. Okay, so for residue 4, what will happen? You know the input will be 0 and 1, and the output, now the output set will change here. So the output will be 0, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so now if you draw a binary string, same automata for this, you know that the number of state will be Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. Okay, so because this is a mod counter, what will happen? Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. Okay, just write it like this and associate, simply associate the output with the state 0, 1, 2. If you draw it, you will again get the right answer by using that. Okay, so it can, it is also valid for mod 5, it is also valid for mod n. Okay, so if you clearly see, if I just draw it by myself, it will take a little bit of time because I have to check every possible number of strings. But when the mod is increased, the complexity will also increase. Okay, so the number of states will increase. I have to again check the same strings for 4 states. If the mod is increased to 5, I have to again check the binary string that is divisible by 5 again and again for 5 states. That will become a whole lot of complex. Okay, so for that, if you want to draw automata, you can follow this method, transition table method, and you will get the same result. If you have any problem, just draw it and see for it yourself, that you will always get the right answer. Okay, so again, the next question is also based on this thing. Okay, so if you see, it says the construct a Moore machine that takes a binary number as input and produces a residue 5 as output. Okay, so I suggest first first try it yourself. Okay, so first try it yourself. After that, you can check it by the shortcut method I have told you. Okay, so concept should be clear. But if your concept is clear, you can go for the shortcut. Okay, so if you completely don't understand it, I don't see the point here. There is no point in cramming that. Okay, most of you, if you have done enough practice, you can see the patterns in the question yourself. Okay, so that is how, if you do more and more practice, you can recognize the patterns in the existing questions also. Okay, so there can be also another patterns in the existing questions that I may not be able to recognize, but if you clearly see that there should be or there can be. Okay, so the next question is a little bit a different question. So question two, try it yourself. I think I have drawn the residue 4. Try to residue 5. First draw it yourself with a pen and a paper. Draw the transition diagram. After that, draw a transition table to check that your transition is correct or not. Okay. So now the next question is a bit different from the usual Miele machines. Okay. So the Miele machine question, it just says it's a very, very easy question. At the first go, it looks a very difficult question, but I think it is one of the easiest question that you will find in Miele machine. What does this question say? That says, again, keep that in mind, that is a Miele machine. It means the output will be placed alongside input. Okay, so on an arrow where there is an output, it will be placed alongside with the input. Okay, keep that in mind. This is a Miele machine. Okay, so it is saying that construct a Miele machine that takes input as binary and returns one's complement. So it means that if we take 0, it will return me 1. If it take me 1, it should return 0. Okay, so that is the only the case here. I think this is one of the easiest question of Miele machine. So just try it yourself. What will you get? I will tell you the answer in like 3 minutes. So I again give you a hint after 1 minute. First, if you try it, I think you can easily draw it. So construction is only based on one thing, that if a 0 is coming, it should be converted to 1. If a 1 is coming, input is 1, it should be converted to 0. Something like that. Okay, so just try it. I will tell you the solution in like 3 minutes. Okay. Okay, so I think Mayank has got the right answer. Again, if anybody wants to try, do not look in the chat box. Just design your own version. Okay, just tell me if you got any other answer. Any other answer? Post your answers. Okay, some of you may be also thinking that it can also happen that whenever there are any number of zeros coming in the starting, it will be converted to 1. After that, if a 1 come, it should be converted to a 0. After that, here, it can be anything, there is no problem with it. So if any number of 1s come, it should be converted to 1 or 0. If any number of zeros come, it should be converted to 1. Okay, so some of you have also designed this, so this is also correct. Okay, so any number of it is just saying that 0 followed by 0 star followed by 1 followed by 1 star, okay, then followed by again a 0 and a 0 star. Okay, so if you clearly see 0 followed by 1 followed by 1 star, then again followed by 0, then again there is a 0 star. So this is a continuous loop here. Okay, so if you draw this is also correct. There is no problem in that. If I just see if anybody can find the problem in this, just tell me. Take a look at it and tell me if you are finding any problem. So 0 can come, single 0 can also come, single 1 can also come. The output is already written on the. So any number of zeros can also come, any number of 1s can also come. 0 can followed by a 1 can also come, 1 followed by 0 star can also come. Okay, so these both combinations are possible, so there is no need to worry about. So this is also correct. Okay, but if you see there is another approach that you can directly say that if any number of 0 come, it should output 1. If any number of 1 come, it should output 0. Okay, so this is also a very valid answer. So how it works, it is just a regular expression. If I just say it is just like 0 plus 1 star. Okay, so it again 0 can also any number of zeros can come afterward, a 1 can also be followed by it, okay? In the same way, any number of ones can start in the beginning. After that, any number of zeros can also be followed by it. Okay, so if I do this, okay, 0 plus 1 star, if you see, is similar to saying this, okay? So I got it, I got this from this, and this is also similar, okay? So I can say that both of these are correct, but it contains minimum number of states, so I would prefer this, okay? So again, there is the thing, no kind of minimization algorithm that exists from Moore and Mealy machine, so don't worry about it. If you're drawing a big automata in that, I don't think there is any need to worry about. So big, this is also correct, as well as this is also correct. So there is no proper minimization algorithm exists for conversion in Moore and Mealy machine, because we do not exactly need it, okay? Now the next question becomes a very tricky question. Okay, so now if you clearly see the next question, it just says that construct a Mealy machine that will do a 2's complement, and there is one line written there. Okay, so what is the one line that is written there? This is one of the most important line. Okay, so it says that assume the string is read from LSB to MSB. So it is saying like this, it is read like this, LSB to MSB. So between 0001, and the end carry is discarded. Okay, so what is the meaning of that? Like, now what is the traditional method to convert any binary string into 2's complement? So just I am writing like this, that 1010. So what you do, first you take 1's complement of it, 1010, then you add plus 1 in it. So it will become this will become your 2's complement. Okay, so now why it is saying that the end carry should be discarded? It is saying that in particular cases like this, okay, 00. Okay, so now what will happen for this 00? It will be complemented. 1's complement is 1 and plus 1 is, so it will become, so it is saying that this carry should be discarded. Okay, so assume the string is read from least significant bit to most significant bit, and the end carry is discarded here. Okay, so exactly the 2's complement answer is this 100 for 00. But by doing this, one string is increasing. Okay, so if you see from 00, one string is increasing. Okay, so if you see that what it is exactly trying to say, that there is a shortcut method that exists for deriving 2's complement. Okay, so that shortcut method does not take into account that carry. So that is why they are saying that you should discard the end carry here. Okay, so that shortcut method, if you give that shortcut method n string, it will again result in n string. Okay, so that is why whenever the strings are increasing, then the input strings, the end carry should be discarded. So this is the condition here, keep that in mind. So this shortcut method is valid for converting any kind of a string into a 2's complement form, but there are some problems that if it is generating a carry, that shortcut is not applicable. So that is why they are saying that you should discard the end carry, only then you can derive a Mealy machine. Okay, so again, if you see the application of Mealy machine, is it is designing in a 2's complement circuit. Okay, so 2's complement circuit, if you studied in digital, is a way to represent a negative numbers. Okay, so negative number system is represented by using a 2's complement, and there are another complement system that also represent negative numbers, that is 1's complement. There is another one, 1's complement is also there, but most of the time 2's complement is preferred, because in all the other system, if you remember the definition, there are two numbers, there are two definitions for zero. That is why we do not prefer it, but in 2's complement form, there is only one definition for zero. That is why 2's complement is right now and Nova used in your digital systems. Right now also, in your computer systems, 2's complement is used to represent negative numbers. Keep that in mind, okay? So now, what is the shortcut here? So suppose this is some string written here. So I can directly convert it into a 2's complement by just saying 001 and then 101. So this is the direct answer of 2's complement. And if you check it, it will get the same result. So 1's complement 1 1 0 1 0 1. If you add it, you will get the same. So 0 0 1 1 0 1. Okay, you will get the same. So how did I do it? So keep just carefully listen. Okay, so this is 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 1. Okay, so whenever there are zeros, write that zeros as it is. Don't worry about that zeros. Whenever there is a one come, write the first one as it is. After that, take a complement of everything. So 1 1 0. Okay, so this will become your two's complement. Okay, so if I again tell you what is the shortcut here, that 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 1 0. Okay, so whenever zero is coming, so just write the zeros as it is. I'm writing the zero as it is. Whenever the first one come, write the first one. After that, take the complement of everything. Okay, so the data will become 1, that will become 0 0 1 0 1 0 1. Okay, keep that in mind, that this method is only applicable whenever there is no carry generating. Okay, so in this case, I know that because this is a zero, there will be no chance that carry will be generated. Okay, so if you understand the concept here, that you should draw a Mealy machine for it. Okay, so clearly think about it. Whenever zeros are coming, it should output 0. Whenever first one come, it should output 1. But after that, it should do a complement. Okay, it should do, after that, it should do a 1's complement. If you just keep in mind that these 3 points, I think you can easily draw the automata. Okay, so just draw a Mealy machine of it. Okay, just try it. Okay, so I think Mayank has absolutely got the right idea. Okay, so if you clearly see what is happening in the starting, any number of zeros can come, it should output me 0. Okay, so whenever the first one come, for the first one, it should output me 1. After that, just complement it. If it is 0, complement it 1. If it is 1, it should output 0. Okay, so that is your answer for this Mealy machine. Okay, so I think the remaining questions are fairly very basic. It's based on the conversion of Mealy to Moore machine. Okay, so this question I think I have done in the class, so there is no need to do that question. Okay, so because if you see, there is zero and it is one is coming from it, and it is again inputting zero here. Okay, so that question we have done in the class. Only one state will increase, Q1 and Q1. So don't do that question. But this question is a very, very good question. Okay, so just try this question. I will tell you the solution. There is something new in this question that you will have seen. There is one thing, there is one concept hidden in that question. But if you just do the question that I have told the method in the class, there is no problem. You will not get a mistake here. So just try that and solve this question and take 5 minutes to solve it. Okay. Post your solution. Okay, so there is a little bit of a typo here. So this is Q0, Q1 and Q2. Sorry for that. So there is a little bit of typo. I will correct it in the final version. So just see, this is Q2. Okay, absolutely right. Okay, so if you clearly see in Mayank's automata, you there is no output associated and Q naught. Okay, so that is the new concept that I'm talking about. Okay, so I tell you how to what to do it. Okay, so if anybody do not understand what I'm talking, so just see this for the explanation and for this Q naught, what you can do, you can for the sake of completion, you can put associate this Q naught with A or with B. Any of the states. So if you do it with A, it is also correct. If you do it with B, it is also correct. Okay. Just let me complete this question. Okay. So just let I am completing. Okay. So what I'm talking about is start from Q naught. Okay. So Q naught on zero is going towards Q one and giving a output of A. I just do that. I cannot do a self loop of zero here because it is going towards Q1 with the output of B. So this is not output of B. So Q1 on getting input of zero is going towards Q1 with the output B. Q1 on getting an input of zero is going towards Q1 with the output of B. That is how I do it. Okay. So now just complete the states. So complete this state first. So 0 is defined here, 1 is remaining. So Q1 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of A. Q1 is going towards Q2 with the output of A. Now this is completed. Complete this Q0. Q0 on 0 is defined. Q0 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of A. Q0 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of A. So that is also completed. Now complete this Q1. Now Q1 on 0 is going towards Q1 with the output of B. Q1 on 0 is going towards Q1 with the output of B. Q1 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of A. Q1 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of A. So that state is also completed. Now complete the states of Q2. Okay. So Q2 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of B. Q2 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of B. Okay, so that is how it will go. So define 0 here. So Q2 on 0 is going towards Q1 with the output of A. Q2 on 0 is going towards Q1 with the output of A. So that is how you define it. Now just complete this, only this state is remaining. Q2 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of B. Q2 on 1 is going towards Q2 with the output of B. Okay, so Q2 on 0 is going towards Q1 with the output of A. Q2 on 0 is going towards Q1 with the output of A. With the output of on 0. Okay. So that is your completed result. So if you see now in the starting state, Q0, there is no output associated with it. Okay, so if that case occurs because nothing is coming towards the initial state here, so that question we haven't dealt till now. Okay, so you can associate with any input that is present. So input, you know, that is A and B. So this is also correct. Q0 A is also correct, or Q0 B is also correct. For the sake of completion, we can do any of the following. Okay, so it is already not defined, so you can use this anyone. Okay, so keep that in mind. That is another scenario that can happen. Okay, so now I think now most of the questions, main questions, have been done, and only there is a conversion from Moore to Mille machine. Okay, so how to convert this into a Mille machine? You can just copy and paste. I think you can easily do this. I don't think that take any amount of time. This is one of the easiest question that can be done. So because this is a Moore machine, so conversion from Moore to Mille will result in the same state. So if it contains Q state, Mille will also contain Q states. But in Mille to Moore conversion, keep that in mind, the states can increase, may or may not increase. Keep that in mind. So in the previous question, we are converting from Mille to Moore machine. So in that case, the states have increased, but it is not always true. Keep that in mind. Okay. So now this is fairly very basic. Just take that output, place it here, take that 1, place it here, take that 1, place it here, take that 2, place it here, take that 2, place it here, and take that 0, place it here. Okay, so this is your resulting Mealy machine. I don't think that this serves any difficult, this is not a very difficult question, this is a very fairly basic question. Okay, so now if you see the last question, it says that Mealy and Moore machine can be categorized as, I have already told you in the lecture that it is categorized as transducers. Okay, so transducer. Okay, so if you studied digital, you have studied transducer. If you do not know what transducer is, what will I do? In the Turing machine, when we are building Turing machine, I will also build a transducer which is based on Turing machine. Okay, so what happens is that if you clearly see this, that you remember the hierarchy, if you remember the hierarchy of the language. Okay, so just let me see what exactly is your badge. Okay, so I think I haven't, I have told you the hierarchy of the languages. Your badge is 3, so I have told you the hierarchy of the languages. In that, what happens is that there is something called a regular language. After that, there is something called context-free language. After that, there is something called context-sensitive. And after that, there is something called recursive set language. Okay, so don't worry about that right now. It is just saying that this RL is the subset of the CFL as well as a CSL as well as this recursive set. In the same way, if you see the finite automata, PDA, LBA, and Turing machine. Okay, so if you clearly see that the lower ranking officer here is your finite automata, in which Moore and Mealy come. The more higher ranking officers are PDA, LBA, and TM. Okay, so if you clearly see that if finite automata is able to accept the regular language, PDA can also do this task, as well as it can also accept the context-free language. In the same way, LBA can also accept regular language as well as CFL, as well as context-sensitive language. Okay, so keep that in mind that FA and PDA is a subset of LBA. In the same way, Turing machine is the superset. So it means that it can again parse regular language, context-free language, context-sensitive language, as well as its own language, that is recursive sets, that is not parsed by any other set. Okay, so if you see the analogy here, that I want to say that the lower ranking officer only do one task. Okay, so this FA can only parse a regular language, but the higher ranking officer from FA can do the work of lower ranking officer as well as its own work also. Okay, so Turing machine can also do the work of all the, because if you see, the lower rank officer get promotion and promoted to a higher rank officer. Okay, so the higher rank officer know the internal working of every department, because he get up there from the lower ranking. Okay, so it means that Turing machine can also do the work that is also done by its lower ranking officer, but it can also perform the additional work that he is supposed to. Okay, so keep that in mind. Now if I'm saying that Moore and Mealy machine, there is a property of transducer, so transducer can also be implemented by the Turing machine. Okay, so I will show that transducer. If you don't know that what is the transducer, I will take one question and solve it, the transducer on Turing machine, so don't worry about that. Okay, so if you do not know transducer, I will explain briefly. Explain briefly when I reach to our Turing machine. Okay. So I think your tutorial 4 is completed and you can move on to the next class. Okay. So I just downloaded your attendance. Okay. So thank you for listening and you can move on to the next class. Again, if you have any doubt, I am here.
Okay, thank you, sir.